The International Association of Business Communicators Philippines recently honored companies and schools that excelled in business communication. Smart Communications won Company of the Year in the 11th Philippine Quill Award. Smart also bagged the top award in communication management for its Project Visa campaign. The Manila Electric Company was first runner-up, followed by the ABS-CBN Corporation. DZMM.com.ph bested all entries in the Communication Skills Division and received an Award of Excellence in the Electronic and Digital Communication category. Meanwhile, De La Salle University's The La Sallean Facebook page won top award in the first Philippine Student Quill Awards. Now joining us in the studio are IABC President Ritzi Ronquillo and the top division winners of the Philippine Quill Awards, De La Salle University student Jessy Marigo, Unilever Philippines' ex-brand manager Jem Laforteza, Smart Communications Incorporated's Executive Vice President and Head of Wireless Consumer Division, Mr. Noel Lorenzana, and DZMM Teleradyo Vice President for Manila Radio Division, among others, Mr. Peter Musngi. Good morning. Thank you very much for joining us
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
The show. Ms. Ritzi, nice to see you again. We have you here almost every year. But this time we're going to be talking about the Philippine Quill Awards. And for those of our viewers who are not familiar with it, can you tell us more about it?
This is an annual flagship program of IABC Philippines. Mm-hmm. This awards all the outstanding and exceptional communication projects made by companies, organizations, foundations, and this year we added schools. So
that's
universities,
right.
We had full-time students who submitted their entries, and we go by an international standard of criteria to judge so that it's a everyone is on level playing field, apples to apples. We go through all the divisions, we have a set of judges, and we then award the winners who are supposed to be best in class and best practice for our industry.
And that's something we have to highlight. This is judged by peers. And you are using international standards, so all of these winners can really go up with any other agency around the world.
Yes, that's right. In fact, some of our Philippine companies and De La Salle that has won this year also has won internationally. And it's ABS-CBN has been a constant winner. And we have other companies that have been winning in the past years.
That's right.
We want to add more winners from the Philippines, and we want to be heard there at world stage. It's very good because with the same set of criteria, you can judge entries from Europe, from North America, Canada, Africa, Asia, from everywhere. We have had winners from Slovenia, actually, internationally. So as we prime everyone to be here, to be exceptional here in the Philippines, we want them to go out also into the world stage. So I think that's one major offering of the Quill Awards. There is a home here in the Philippines, and you can vie for international awards also there, which is held every June at the World Conference in North America, or sometimes it's held in Canada. By the way, if I may plug, IABC Philippines, which is doing this award every year as its flagship program, is celebrating its 30th anniversary this year. So we really want it to be special this year.
Okay, let's talk to the winners. This is the first time you held a Philippine a Student Quill Awards, and the winner goes to De La Salle University. Tell us about the La Sallean Facebook page.
So a couple of years ago, we started the La Sallean Facebook page that would supplement our monthly published issues. So it's also linked to our other social networking accounts like Twitter and our website, thelasallean.com. So whenever we post articles, photos, it immediately gets posted to the other social networking accounts. So we are able to reach our readers, our audience, and when whatever online platform they prefer.
Pero hindi naman puro mga lasalisa lang.
No,
no. Titignan lang din ng iba.
Yes. It's UAAP is popular in our Facebook page. So whatever school you're from, we get visits from UAAP fans.
Eh, UAAP naman talaga. Eh. Madami talagang followers. Okay, Jem, you brought with you the winning entry, a creative packaging of, what do you call it?
It's a survival kit. Yep.
So tell us about what's inside the survival kit. Why come up with a survival kit?
So we... Our then new fragrance, which is Axe 2012, is a way for us to really
end the world with the bang. Mm-hmm.
Of course, we were talking about the end of the world last year, which
yes,
didn't happen.
Supposedly, mm-hmm. it should have happened yes. December 21, but it didn't, apparently. Mm-hmm. But months before that, we came out with this survival kit, mm-hmm. which is, you know, there are a lot of useful stuff in it you can use in case, you know, we get into trouble.
Yes.
And if things get really hopeless, then you can also use these things to enjoy yourself.
Mm-hmm. Enjoy yourself.
Enjoy like yourself how? With someone else.
Okay, show us what's inside. So, you were showing your favorite thing inside.
My favorite
aside
inside
from the fragrance
is this. You know, you
can and use what it is to, that for?
It's a handcuff. It's mm-hmm. It's a kind handcuff. You know, so you can use it to detain someone in case they're being in trouble while the world
without
is
harming
ending.
That person.
Without harming them.
It's
that's
just
why you
for
have the. That's why you have the fluff in there.
That's very thoughtful of you. Yep, so, and what else is inside?
You can also use like there's a bottle of fuel in it.
Mm-hmm.
You can use that, you know, to make fire, probably. Use it on someone something else. Sorry.
Okay, if you give us a package, Paolo and I will be inspecting the contents of that.
Yes,
and also the don't have to see the handcuff anymore. Of course, ABS-CBN DZMM came up with its own website. Si Sir Peter, kinuha na lahat eh. Hindi lang radio. You're also on cable TV, of course, with Teleradyo, and then you have your own website. Tell us more about it, sir.
Well, you know, this is the first time that we won any award for our website.
Mm-hmm.
So this is really a giant leap mm-hmm. you know, for DZMM in our continuing evolution. And I think it's very significant because we are now reaching to audiences, not just in Luzon or in the Philippines, mm-hmm. but outside as well. So I guess it doesn't really matter whether you're connected with the Filipino channel. You can access our DZMM website mm-hmm. and the audio streaming also.
That's right.
DZMM. Mm-hmm.
Live audio streaming, yeah. as it happens, as yeah. they're airing.
Yes, wherever you are. So we're very grateful to IABC for this wonderful award.
And of course, the website would also show previous shows or important interviews that you had. You have links to, aside from the updated stories, your archive is also there. So you can probably yeah. listen to an interview you missed in the morning. It's still going to be in the site.
Yes, it works that way. But more than that, it's an interactive website. So our listeners and our viewers mm-hmm. can actually upload photos mm-hmm. or even tip us off on some breaking news somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
For public service purposes, they can ask their favorite anchor or our mm-hmm. public service center to get them some assistance from the government or whatever agency they need.
And this is the second time that you've received an award from the IABC Philippines. Last year, it was last time it was the Kapamilya Shawarna
yes.
program.
Yeah, that broke the ice for us. And then we had several awards and finalists.
Of course, the
categories.
CEO XL award. Parang permanent fixture na si Sir Peter sa IABC Philippines in your awards. Thank you very much for talking to
Thank
us about
you.
The website, sir. Mr. Noel, Project Visa and a lot of other campaigns. I was there during the awarding ceremony and we heard SMART being mentioned the whole yeah. night. Tell us about Project Visa and all of your other campaigns this year that won you Company of the Year award.
Well, Project Visa was a project by SMART that actually helps subscribers use and guide them using the self-care service of SMART, you know. A lot of people want to use the services, inquire about their account, inquire about the promos in a fast, simple way.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we thought, you know, why don't, you know, we apply it in a way that's mobile, online, and in a kiosk. And the good thing about it, the self-service project actually raised the customer satisfaction ratings. People actually were very happy to actually be able to control their destiny when controlling their mobile services, mm-hmm. and they were just too happy to do it, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, with these campaigns, I ask the both of you, the more senior ones, if you would excuse us, in the industry. But is this a conscious effort to win those awards? Like for the Philippine Quill Awards, you make a project thinking that I would want to get this award for this year, or you just create the project out of your own advocacies, and it's just a bonus for you. Mr. Noel, go ahead.
I think first and foremost, SMART aims to serve the customers in the best possible way. You know, customer service is at the core of our value system. Mm-hmm. So if a prestigious body like the IABC recognizes our efforts, then that's very good for us. In fact, it encourages our people to actually do better and do more things. So it's all about focusing on the customer, and if we get recognized for it, then it actually pushes people to do better.
Sir Peter?
It doesn't hurt to win an award. It's enjoyable to win an award. Mm-hmm. But I guess in the case of DZMM.com.ph, it is really a part of the survival tactics that we have. So we just don't want to survive, we want to thrive. You know, from a simple radio station to a cable TV channel, and now on the web too. I think a whole new generation of young people are growing up with practically no association and loyalty to radio. Mm-hmm. And we're trying to go where they are, introduce the values of listening to radio, watching Teleradyo, and at the same time, be able to communicate in their own space and in their language.
Jem, mm-hmm. for some departments, some creative agencies, I know that's one of the goals, aside from it being your job, but for most people, it is something they aim for, that I want to win this award, be it international, be it local. Does it hurt to aim for an award from any award-giving body?
Well, it doesn't hurt, of course. It feels good, and it motivates the whole team,
right,
to really push the envelope, mm-hmm. and really, you know, do better and better and better every year. But primarily, it's about coming up with stuff that people enjoy, mm-hmm. and that you would enjoy yourself, mm-hmm. right?
As so you were saying a while ago. Yeah.
So, yes, but we appreciate, you know, every award that we get, especially from the Quill Awards and the IABC.
Jessy, any advice for the other students who will be joining the next awards, Philippine Quill Awards?
What everyone said, you have to know and embrace the needs of your audience, mm-hmm. your market. For us, our readers. So you really have to embrace that. And then you have to be critical of your work. What everyone said as well, that you have to continue to motivate yourself to be the benchmark of mm-hmm. your industry students. For us to continue to be the bastion of issue-oriented critical thinking in our university and among our peers, among mm-hmm. other publications. Mm-hmm. So it's a constant push for us to strive for excellence.
Okay, Ms. Ritzi, for this year, what's going to be... what are you going to do to make it special? You did mention that it's your 30th anniversary already. What's going to be different this year?
We're currently studying the new categories and the new divisions because we evolved from, we cascade from international. And one strength of the Quill is that it's very strong on research, and it's also very strong on people development as well as continuous learning. And what we encourage here is you have fun, you create, but you must have relevance to your organization that has to push your organization forward. And collectively, hopefully, every organization that does that collectively will push our country forward. So that's on many perspectives that we look at it. We're currently studying two new divisions. So one would be on research, communication research for both internal, external.
Research.
I'm very sure a lot of research agencies, researchers and schools would be very interested, academe. Likewise, we're studying now the other category of training, internal communication training, both internally again and externally, because it's one of the strengths. So we have three pillars in IABC, which is a worldwide pillar. Mm-hmm. We have content, which we are very certain we have with all our winners.
Of
excellent
course.
Content. Mm-hmm. We tell them every year, make the judges scratch their heads and say, I have a hard time, my God, what will I...
Give them a hard time.
Give them a hard time. And then we have also career. We want to take care of the career of our members, uh-huh. make them be fulfilled, and make them develop into competent and experienced ethical communicators. And of course, grow IABC and its advocacy. So we all come from Asia Pacific. So I sat in as regional director for Asia Pacific, mm-hmm, specifically North Asia. Mm-hmm. And we want the Asia part of our life here to be part of an international org. I keep telling them that we're not international. if we don't bring in other parts of the world.
That's
so
right, that's
Asia
right.
Pacific has a lot of cultures, a lot of ways of communicating that will enrich and enhance it at global level. So we're so excited. And they know that when we attend the conferences, in which there will be a leadership institute this coming month, they know they will hear from the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what IABC Philippines is for.
Okay, Ms. Ritzi Ronquillo of IABC Philippines. Of course, the 12th Philippine Quill Awards will be aired here on ANC tomorrow, January 23, 10:30 p.m. That's right after the World Tonight. And on January 27 at 9:30 in the morning, we'd like to thank our guests, Jessy Marigo of De La Salle, Jem Laforteza of Axe and Unilever Philippines, Mr. Noel Lorenzana of SmartM, and of course, Mr. Peter Musngi of ABS-CBN DZMM. Thank you very much for joining us here in the studio.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Businesses in New Orleans are gearing up for the Super Bowl. And PETA presents the Wonder Twins of